be the one that might see you soon. Taylor, believe me when I say this gift is not a joke about being on time. Here it is. I'll admit it. It's often me. I'm not sure what I can say to make you understand the love I have for you today and every day. It's constantly evolving. I've loved every version of you and every stage of growth. I just feel it become more solidified with each season of life we experience. There were moments of my life before that seemed so bare. You added color and laughter and a lightness that I didn't know. I worried for the longest time that I was buried in it all, but it turns out I was planted, and there you were to help me grow. You made me see that going with your gut is the answer, and that you were meant to be my always. My suns will rise and set on you, my love, in this beautiful light we have created. Till the wheels come off, love, Crystal. Can't handle this today. Oh, we got options. She's gonna be so pissed when she has to read mine because mine's a lot longer.
I don't know. To the love of my life, I can't begin to explain how excited I am to finally get to see you walk down the aisle today. Since the day we met, I knew we would be here today, and I can't believe we are finally here. I keep reminiscing of the earlier days of our relationship, and I can't stop thinking about our walk home that one night to your apartment, kissing in the pouring rain, saying I love you for our first time. It was wild how quickly we fell in love, but since that day, I knew you were the one, and that someday I would marry you and make you my wife. I know it may not be the traditional way of doing life, but getting to spend this day with not only you, but also our beautiful children will be a memory I will cherish forever. Crystal, you will never understand how much you truly mean to me, and I promise to show you every day how amazing of a husband I can be. I hate to quote Zach Bryan on our special day, but when he said, find someone who grows flowers in the darkest parts of you, it never hit me so hard. I found a love that I never knew was possible with the most perfect person in the world. You have made me such a better person, and although not every day may feel like it, you've had such an impact on me that I'll forever be grateful for. Who I am today is because of you, and I owe you the world for that. Not leaving your apartment that day and overstaying my visit has led to an amazing life so far, and I can't wait to continue this adventure together. The honor of being able to call you my wife is something I will never take for granted. Today you officially become Miss Weeks, and that is so wild and crazy. I love you to the moon and back, Taylor. Oh, man. Oh.
That is so cute. I love
it. Oh, that's so nice.
Such a wedding scent.
Oh, what a doll. He knows me too well.
Baptized in your name. as the waltzes or leaves. Been rushing through my timber till your love brought on the spring. Now the mountains all blushing, and they don't know what to say. Except a good long line of praises for my lovely Lady May. Now I ain't the toughest hickory that your axe has ever felled, but I'm a hickory just as well. I'm a hickory all the same. I came crashing through the forest as you cut my roots away. And I fell a good long way for my lovely lady.
Please be seated. Come to center. Come to center. Ladies and gentlemen, family and friends of the bride and groom, welcome to the beautiful New London Carriage House to celebrate the love of Crystal Hill and Taylor Weeks. My name is Jeff Kowalski, and I am honored to preside over Taylor and Crystal's wedding today. As the bride and groom stand before us, they embrace not only their own love, but also the profound love shared between each of them and all of you, their cherished family and friends. Your presence in this moment ensures that Taylor and Crystal are enveloped by the warmth and support of those they hold closest to their hearts, and they thank you for being here. In addition to those present, we acknowledge those who are not here with us, but who are certainly sharing the excitement and joy with the couple from elsewhere, and those people are dearly missed. In order to prepare for today's ceremony, I asked Crystal and Taylor some questions individually about their relationship to give me a bit more insight into their love and history together. In reading the answers to their questions, it was obvious to me that they have built a firm foundation for their beautiful family and have set their priorities and values together to ensure a loving future. It was also clear that, given their respective senses of humor, they were both nervously intrigued about what the other's answers would be. Crystal and Taylor's story begins the way most modern love stories do. And of course, that means Taylor found an excuse to message Crystal over Instagram and ultimately asked her out. The running joke is that the first time Taylor went to Crystal's place, he just never left. They both say they fell in love so quickly, even more so when Crystal met Taylor's daughter, Mackenzie, and Taylor watched them become fast friends. Likewise, Crystal realized Taylor's loyalty and selflessness toward his loved ones, cementing the feeling she had for him. Since that fateful Instagram DM, the two have been inseparable and have built an impressive family and life together. Now, marriage isn't going to change much on a day-to-day basis for you two. You will continue working together to bring your family closer to its goals, and you will continue pushing each other to be the best partners and parents that you can be. What marriage will do is bring you and your respective families closer together, forges your future together, and will require the same passion and persistence moving ahead as what got you here today.
Hi.
In a timely entrance, Crystal and Taylor agree that their most amazing accomplishment together is the birth of their children. Taylor and Crystal have each stated how incredible the other is as a parent, and how the love for one another has grown alongside the growth of their children. One look at the five of them together demonstrates Taylor and Crystal's ability to navigate life's challenges and joys as a team. Taylor and Crystal, the love and commitment you have shown in creating a strong foundation for your family is truly inspiring. As you embark on this journey of marriage, remember that your accomplishments as individuals are magnified when you work together. Through your shared dreams, shared goals, and shared efforts, you will continue to build an extraordinary life filled with love and laughter. Always remember to support one another, cherish each other's achievements, and face any obstacles with unwavering unity. Your love and dedication to one another will be the driving force behind your future milestones and as you create a lifetime of shared memories. And although you've been building your beautiful family for some time now, you're taking the next step in your family's journey.
I want more lipstick.
Anyone have lipstick?
I don't have any lipstick. Okay. I think I need some more lipstick.
Right there.
We
got your
lipstick.
There you go.
I want to get lipstick. Mama, I don't want to get some
lipstick. Okay, you just stay here. We'll get some after, okay?
Oh, Evie. Alexa's over there and wants to see you with Asher.
No.
I think she uses everything.
She knows where
your lipstick. Taylor and Crystal.
And Everly.
You are transitioning from two individuals in love to a married couple with their futures intertwined. Not only are you coming together as individuals, you're bringing with you all of the love and support that you've already been receiving your whole lives, and you can see here today. Through the love and support of the people here, you've not only learned the ability to feel love and give love, but the desire to receive love. And you've now filled each other's desire for love, and that is something remarkable to hold. On the topic of love, the bride and groom would ask that Ashley Brophy please come forward to offer a reading simply titled, Love. You can tilt that down a little bit if you need to.
Love by Roy Croft. I love you, not only for what you are to me, but for what I am when I'm with you. I love you, not for what you have made of yourself, but for what you are making of me. I love you for the part of me that you bring out. I love you for putting your hand into my heaped up heart and passing over all the foolish, weak things that you can't help but dimly seeing there, and drawing out into the light all of the beautiful belongings that no one else had looked quite hard enough to find. I love you because you are helping me to make the lumber of my life not a tavern, but a temple. Of the works of my everyday, not a reproach, but a song. I love you because you have done more than any creed could have done to make me good, and more than any fate could have done to make me happy. You have done it without a touch, without a word, without a sign. You have done it by being yourself. Perhaps that is what being a friend means after all. Roy Croft.
Crystal and Taylor have prepared their own vows to share with one another, and we'll turn to Crystal to share hers first.
Taylor, about 4.5 years ago, we started this journey, and right away you told me, I'm going to marry you. And I laughed, maybe a little nervously, thinking that that was crazy. But deep down, I was thinking maybe I was a little crazy too, because nothing made me happier than hearing you say those words. Now, here we are with our amazing little family, and I realize that crazy is a very subjective term, because I've never been happier. So these things I promise to you. To love you with my whole heart. Even when you're leaving socks and disposable toothpicks for every inch of our home. To make time for us, even when we feel there are no more hours in the day. You're my love and my best friend, and carving out us time is my top priority. To let you win a game of crib, only every now and then. To support your hopes and dreams as my own and always be in your corner. To practice my patience, especially during golf, when you give me a play-by-play of your shot that I just watched you take for the second time because the first one was a mulligan. To put you and your family, you and our family first, and never take for granted this beautiful life that we have built together. To always laugh at your dad jokes, and to always look for our next adventure because every day is better with you by my side. And lastly, I vow to be the best parts of me that fit perfectly with the best parts of you. I love you.
This isn't going to go good. Crystal, it's not easy being the best thing to ever happen to you. If we're being honest, though, we can all admit that you're the best thing to ever happen to me. You'll truly never understand the ways you've changed my life and how you've made me be. And how you made me become a better person. As we both often say, when you know, you know. I know I'll always be there for you, no matter what. I know I'll always be by your side, whether we're walking or running. I know I can't solve all of your problems, but I know you won't have to face them alone. I know you have the biggest heart out of anyone I know, and I promise to give you all of mine. I know you're the best mom in the world, and our kids are so lucky to have you as a mom. God damn it.
Got this, buddy.
I know I spent 26 years thinking I'd never change for anyone, but I know you changed me for the better. I know I'll spend the rest of my life trying to be the very best man you deserve. I know I'll work as hard as possible to provide for our family and give us the life I know you deserve. I know you're my best friend, my soulmate, and my everything. I know I'll always support you and be there for you. I know I'll give you my forever. I know you're better at me in golf, in crib, and maybe Catan. And I know you'll always take forever to get ready, and I know I'll always be late for everything. I'll try not to keep score, even when I know I'm clearly winning. I know I'll continue to force you to listen to Zach Bryan on repeat. I hope you know that no one compares to you. You're one in a million. You're my one in a million. I love you. Good.
Landon.
Just my allergies.
Bring the ring. Challenge. Give the ring. here. Oh, I can hold on to this.
Sure.
No, you don't need to turn. You have it? Here's in here. Okay, so the second time we go through, you'll get to the rings, okay? So Taylor, we'll start with you, okay? Please repeat after me.
I'm not good at this.
I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know of no lawful impediment.
That I know of no unlawful impediment.
Why I, Taylor Walter Weeks.
Why I, Taylor Walter Weeks.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Dallas Crystal Hill.
To Dallas Crystal Hill.
Crystal, same thing. I do solemnly declare.
I do solemnly declare.
That I know of no lawful impediment.
That I know of no lawful impediment.
Why I, Dallas Crystal Hill.
Why I, Dallas Crystal Hill.
May not be joined in matrimony.
May not be joined in matrimony.
To Taylor Walter Weeks.
To Taylor Walter Weeks.
Now Taylor again. I, Taylor Walter Weeks.
I, Taylor Walter Weeks.
Take you, Dallas Crystal Hill.
Take you, Dallas Crystal Hill.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
Do you accept this ring?
Do you accept this ring?
I do.
No.
Same thing. I, Dallas Crystal Hill.
I, Dallas Crystal Hill.
Take you, Taylor Walter Weeks.
Take you, Taylor Walter Weeks.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
Do you accept this ring?
Do you accept this ring?
I do.
Watch yourself. We'll just take a brief pause to sign the marriage statement and ask that Shallon and Landon join us at the signing table, please.
I would suggest that a great marriage requires regular celebration, although I'm not entirely sure you two need the encouragement to have a little fun. This ceremony today is, in its own right, an amazing accomplishment worthy of celebration. But so is tomorrow, when you wake up for the first time as a married couple. And the days, weeks, and years after that. There's so much in your lives together that will require celebration. So I simply encourage you to celebrate your marriage and your family and your milestones every day moving forward. Finding love like yours, being married to one another, is not an insignificant feat, nor is it a small privilege. You have chosen to commit to one another in this life, and that is special. Congratulations. I, Jeffrey Kowalski, by the virtue of the powers vested in me by the Marriage Act in the province of Prince Edward Island, pronounce you husband and wife, and you may now share your first kiss as a married couple.
Gentlemen, friends, family, and loved ones. We will be your MCs for the evening. My name is Spencer, and this is my partner in crime tonight, Bailey Penny. We will be here trying to keep things on track to the best of our ability, making sure everybody has some fun. You also are more than welcome to call me Squirtle, a nickname I've been known by for many years. And for some of you, you might have known me, Alan, for about 12 years and didn't realize until about a month ago that that wasn't my actual name. So I go by both, and I'm very easy. You know, they both work for me.
Who's Spencer?
You know, we're up here to have some fun with you. Our goal, both of us tonight, is to be probably the soberest people by 10 p.m. and the drunkest people in the room by 11. With that said, I encourage everyone to come and see us between those hours and buy us a drink.
We now have some lovely people we'd like to formally introduce this evening. First off, I have the pleasure of introducing the mother and father of the bride, Karen Hill and Boyd Hill.
Next up, we would like to introduce the mother and father of the groom, Phyllis and Alan Weeks.
Now to introduce the head table. On your left, we have the beautiful bridesmaids. First, we are proud to introduce the daughter of the bride and groom, big sister of Everly and Asher, and the preteen with the biggest attitude in the room. I didn't write this, Mackenzie. I didn't. Next, we have the groom's favorite sister, Phyllis's favorite daughter, the potato princess, and the top wedding planner in the room, Hannah Weeks. Woo! Taylor is excited to announce our next bridesmaid. She's a friend of the bride, enemy of the groom, and a Calvert's top bachelorette candidate, Angie McNally. Woo! Next up, we have the floating party queen, an event planner who gets the bride and groom hungover twice a year after Shellfish and Wine Fest, friend of the bride, Jen Painter. Longtime friend of the bride, her partner in crime, and the one with the best, worst, and worst influence on the bride, Miss Kennedy Longaby. Sorry, that was Kendall. Sorry, Kendall. Last but not least, we have the maid of honor, the only one to drink mimosas without orange juice for breakfast twice a week. Godmother of Everly Blake and Crystal's ride or die, Shallon Hendry. Woo!
Now it's time for us to introduce the less attractive half of the wedding party.
Whoa! You're gonna start over there.
I wrote these questions all by myself, I swear. On the far right, we have someone who was too good for Hunter River and had to move to the farthest point of PEI, the groom's best friend, and apparently his favorite cousin as well, Cody Weeks. Next up, we have the most handsome resident of Clyde River. Debatably, the second best hockey player in the room, besides the groom. And the husband of PEI's number one social media influencer, Jason Cameron. Hey! Next, we have the pride and joy of Rexton, New Brunswick. The groom's tallest friend and the favorite uncle of Crystal and Taylor's children, my little buddy, Mr. AJ Dasher Doyle. Next up, we would like to introduce the next top contender for the Bachelor of the Calgary Stampede, the man who traveled the farthest to be here with us today, who also had to use Gorilla Glue to fix his fake tooth this week for about the seventh time, and the most likely to be the first one here tonight to take their shirt off, Mr. Zacharno. That heat, though, I don't know. I was pretty close to give you a run for that one. Most of you know this next individual. He's Taylor's number one fan as a child. He wanted to name Landon Moore Taylor. And to this day, he still holds a grudge against Phyllis for not doing so. The only Weeks brother who knows what hard work is and doesn't sit at their phone all day long at the desk. The older brother of the groom and the co-best man, Mitch Weeks. The final groomsman to announce is someone who tries so hard to be like the groom. He went to the same university that Taylor did. He got the same stupid tattoo that Taylor did. He chose the same career that Taylor did. The PEI property sister, the only person to be banned for going back to the Burt, the little brother of the groom and co-best man, Landon Weeks. Now that all these hooligans have been introduced, it's time for us to get some food into ourselves. Although, as Taylor likes to say, eating is cheating. We are very excited for tonight's Southern barbecue feast.
Before we start dinner this evening, we'd like to call up the grandmother of the groom, Noreen McKenna, to say grace for the evening. Woo!
Can you all hear me? Thank you, God, our Father, for gathering us around this table to celebrate the love and commitment of Crystal and Taylor as they share their first meal as husband and wife. We thank you for the gift of their presence in our lives. They have touched each one of us with their generous love, their unselfish support, and their unfailing kindness to all. Bless their future with the virtues of faith, hope, and love. May they always enjoy good health and every happiness. Bless this food that the farmers who have produced it and the hands that have carefully prepared it. Keep us mindful of those who are in need of nourishment. We ask these things in the name of your Son, Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Noreen, for those lovely words. Very, very kind.
You are going to see an amazing pile of Mars bars. And it is very random, yes, but there is purpose behind that. The reason that we have the Mars bars, and some of you will understand, is that there's someone really special that we wish was here with us tonight, and that is Grammy Weeks. Everyone knows how much she means to us, and we would do anything to have her here for this special moment. So, as most of you know, Taylor started Grammy's Gifts in her honor, and it was amazing to receive so much support and many from people that are in this room here today. So, Grammy often gave the kids Mars bars, and somehow it stuck around and it did become a tradition. Even at her funeral, Aunt Dar made sure that everyone had one last Mars bar from Gram. So, it only felt right to at least include Grammy here this evening in some way. So, everybody, at some point in the evening, please go up and grab a Mars bar in honor of Sweet Louise, please.
Thank you for saying what I wrote, Chris. Now that you see this, I don't know if people saw in the programs, Zach and Dasher,
shut up.
In the bottom right-hand corner, there's the POV app, and there's a barcode there. I don't know if everyone's seen that. That's not funny, Dasher. I don't know if people have seen it or not. It's kind of like a disposable camera app. So if you guys want to scan it on your phone, everyone gets to take, I think it's 20 or 25 photos. So you don't get to see the photos. It automatically goes into, say, the magical cloud. And then it gets released to Crystal and I tomorrow. So if everybody wants to look at the program, I think there's some more up at the front. There's some up here too. Anyways, it's just kind of a cool thing we wanted to do. And then we can go through all the photos tomorrow. And then I think we get the option to share it with everybody else.
Keep it PG.
Keep it PG, please. I don't want to hold the microphone anymore. Spencer, come here.
All right. Welcome back. You have to deal with us for a little bit longer. I hope that everybody had a wonderful meal and is almost finished eating or is getting through the delicious meal and not falling asleep yet. That's, I think, my risk at the moment. As people wrap up their meals and continue to enjoy the lovely food, we are going to start in on some speeches this evening from some very important people here in the room. So the first people that we would like to invite up are the parents of the groom, Phyllis and Big A.
Phyllis and who?
I think you. If you'd like.
Oh, sorry, honey.
All right, you guys are off. Let's steal your seats.
Welcome, everyone. As most of you know, we're Taylor's parents, Phyllis and Alan. On behalf of Alan and myself, we'd like to thank you for joining us today as we celebrate the beautiful bride and groom.
Can't do it, fellas.
We would like to thank all those who have traveled from far and away to be with them today. All of his forever friends from St. Evex, his friend Zach, his aunt Ida, his cousin Emily and Jason and their baby McKenna, and our dear family friends since our kids were very little, Rick and Gabe. We would also like to give a big thank you to all who have helped them with their wedding arrangements over the past few months. And a special thank you to his sister Hannah, who conveniently fell into the role of wedding coordinator, since she is the only one in the family who is organized and hates when things are unplanned and late. There's some people here today who would have heard me say, when the kids were growing up, that Taylor was our mediator. One of the boys never listened, and the other boy had selective hearing. But Dad and I could always count on Taylor smoothing things over. When I would be at work, I could expect a call from Alan saying something was going sideways. I would just say, put Taylor on the phone. Taylor and I would have a chat, we'd hang up, and Taylor would talk his brothers into doing whatever Dad needed done. Many know how close Taylor and Hannah were growing up. The night before she was starting junior high, she was no longer looking forward to it like she had been all summer. Nothing I said eased her nervousness. Taylor came home and said, write down all your questions that you are nervous about. He answered all of them for her, and at the bottom of the page he wrote, don't worry about anything, I'll always be here for you. Taylor, these are only a few of the reasons we're reminded of how blessed we are to have you as our son. Anyone who knows Taylor knows how generous and kind he is. When he was in elementary school, he asked for money for the book fair. I only had a $10 bill, and I told him he was only allowed to buy one book and had to bring the change back. So when he got home from school, he couldn't wait to show me the book he got. He looked at it, and then I asked him where the change was, and he started to cry and said, a little boy in my class had no money to buy a book, and I gave him the money. I told Taylor, you are Grammy's grandson, for sure. Here we are 20 years later, and Taylor creates Grammy's gifts this past Christmas. He organized a gift drop-off for kids that may not get a present in memory of Grammy Weeks, who spread more Santa memories than anyone. Grammy and Grampy would be so proud of you, Taylor. Aunt Dara was looking through old bins of Grammys yesterday because she knew Grammy had written a letter a long time ago that was to be read at her grandchildren's wedding. She searched for it before Hannah's, but no success, and decided to search again yesterday and found it. So I'll read it for you, Taylor. Oh. If I can. Words of wisdom to my grandchildren. I've traveled paths you've yet to walk, learned lessons old and new, and now this wisdom of my life I'm blessed to share with you. Let kindness spread like sunshine, embrace those who are sad. Perfect their dignity, give them a hug, and leave them feeling glad. Express what you are feeling, your beliefs you should uphold. Don't shy away from what is right, be courageous as you grow old. Always have family dinners and celebrate birthdays too. Then I'm sure you'll think of what Grammy used to do. The world is far from perfect. There's conflict and there's strife, but you can always make a difference by the way you live your life. I am so blessed to know the wonders you'll all do. Because you are my grandchildren, I love and believe in all of you. I love Grammy Weeks, January 2012. Taylor, you have made your dad and I so proud to be your parents. When you became a dad yourself at such a young age, we, of course, were unsure that your future might not be the same as you or us thought it would be. We made sure you still got to live out your dream of going to St. Evex, but you always made Mackenzie your main priority. You made the most of the time you had with her when you would come home. I always remember how loving and caring you were with that little baby, and we're determined to be the best dad. Taylor, you have definitely succeeded, and when we see you with Mackenzie, Everly, and Asher, you have definitely made us the proudest grandparents with your beautiful family. Now, time to talk about our beautiful daughter-in-law. Crystal, you look absolutely stunning today.
I look good, too. Pants are a little short.
Growing up, Taylor had as many girlfriends as he had guy friends. We always knew that whoever he chose to be his lifetime partner would need to have as big a personality as he did. He definitely found that new Crystal. When we met you that first Christmas, you were together, it was so easy to see that you were a match. With your outgoing personality and your ease around our crazy family, you fit right in. I remember watching Taylor, Mackenzie, and you play a game on the living room floor and thinking, she is so good with the most important little human in his life. You had me convinced then, and now watching you with all your little ones and how patient, loving, and caring you were, it's a parent's dream come true to know our son has found his one true love. Boyd and Karen, you have raised a beautiful woman both inside and out. As parents, we hope to raise our children to be caring, honest, responsible, and hardworking young adults. Crystal is all of these, and we know you must be so proud. We know we are honored to have her join our family and proudly welcome her to the Weeks clan. Taylor and Crystal, all the things you have and will ever have will fade away sooner or later. But there's only one thing that will last forever, and it's your love for each other. To love someone deeply gives you strength. Being loved by someone deeply gives you courage. On behalf of all our family, we congratulate you and Crystal and wish you a lifetime of love, joy, and happiness. In closing, Crystal, I just need to say one thing. Thank you for not running. And another thing, I said what I said.
Yes,
Thank you very much for those lovely words. Next up, we will now ask the parents of the bride, Karen Hill and Boyd Hill.
That's a hard act to follow.
Good evening, everyone. We are so happy to welcome Taylor into our family. We welcome the first time we met him a few years ago at Christmas. A short time after, Crystal told us she was the happiest she has ever been, and for that, we thank you, Taylor. We lovingly often call Crystal number one, as she is our only child, and then therefore has always had all our love. And today, we wish her much love and happiness. She and Taylor are the most fabulous parents to our grandchildren. One Christmas, Taylor gave me the most beautiful Christmas tree.
As you've seen on the
ever, which was constructed of many, many cans of Alpine, which we enjoyed for several months following Christmas. Seriously, we really want to say how pleased we are to welcome you to our family and to thank you both for our three beautiful grandchildren that we adore. A short time after meeting Taylor, we were so happy to meet Mackenzie, and we welcomed her and considered her immediately as our granddaughter. Later, we were blessed with Everly, and love her and enjoy her spicy little personality so much. Later came Asher, who is such a handsome and sweet little boy. We look forward to seeing them grow and wish them much health and happiness in their lives. We thank you again, Taylor, for loving Crystal the way you do, as she has always been number one in our hearts. Thank you, and everyone enjoy the evening. Thank you.
Those are a couple hard acts to follow. I'm not envious of the next guest we're bringing up here. Some beautiful speeches from both sets of parents. Thank you so much for that. Next up, we would like to invite the maid of honor, Shalyn Murray.
Thanks, guys. Nothing like getting the tears going before I get up here. Thanks, parents. I did stupidly put this speech on the table and spilled a little bit of wine on it, so I'm really hoping that I can still read this, but we'll see how it goes. I'm very honored to be here to toast and celebrate two of my really good friends today. Dallas and I were lucky to meet through mutual friends pretty late in life. We've really just been close friends sometime within the last 10 years. And I don't often get the opportunity to compliment this woman in front of so many people, so I will take this opportunity. And if you know Dallas, she always brings so much positive energy to every room she enters. She is my yes woman. She is a cheerleader for everybody that she loves in her life, and I know that she would have my back no matter what, no questions asked. I can't really pinpoint the exact moment where you became my person, Dal. But through many trips around the globe, really good chats, and many, many, many nights closing down the old Dublin, we became two peas in a pod. So as Dallas and I were living our best single carefree lives,
along came Taylor Weeks in Dooley's of all places. And it's been mentioned already tonight, but I have to reiterate, because Crystal and I always tease our husbands that we both went on first dates with them and then they just never ever left our apartment again. And Phyllis actually recently confirmed for me, Taylor, that you only popped home to pick up fresh clothes, so I don't think that's really a joke after all.
It's very true.
So we aren't sure if I became the third wheel that day, or more likely it was Taylor, but the three of us trotted off to Mexico. And if it wasn't clear to me before that, it certainly was after that trip that we were all gonna be here someday at your wedding. I can't think of another couple that is so truly meant for each other. I think if you guys had lived on opposite sides of the planet, you still would have found each other somehow. Taylor, thank you for loving my best friend so much. I am so happy that I have two friends now in Mr. and Mrs. Weeks and a realtor. And three amazing Weeks children to spoil. I hope you guys have felt all the love and support you have around you, especially this week and today. I love you both as individuals and now as husband and wife. Congrats, fam. I love you guys.
Next up for speeches, we have Mitch Weeks, one of the coolest men.
Well, shit. Let's bring this up here. I've made a few words. I'm not going to be able to live up to everything that was just said, but let's give our best. I hope everyone's having a good time tonight, and everyone's privileged and honored, or I'm very privileged and honored to be standing here tonight celebrating this beautiful union. I felt that since it was Taylor's wedding, I should write my speech in typical Taylor fashion, so I wrote this last night. Being Taylor's older brother, there's not many people that have known him longer than myself, so I know all the good and the bad, but luckily for him, I'm only going to talk about the good tonight. But before I get into that, I just want to express how happy we are to finally add Crystal to this crazy, crazy family. Taylor and Crystal met while I still lived in Alberta, so our introduction was delayed. But I knew he had found a keeper when she continuously allowed me to barge into their home at 2 a.m. for 2 weeks at a time, twice a year. And by the way, I still haven't found a way to not wake Mosby up. But back to my main man, Tilly. I know I said I wasn't going to talk about the good, but it's kind of tough when there's so much bad. Like your favorite winged hairstyle growing up, and your favorite girl jeans that you said were a better fit. But luckily for you, that's all the bad I'm going to get into tonight. Being an only child for a short amount of time, you would think I'd be sick of mom coming home with more kids. But when little old Landy came around, mom asked me what I thought his name should be, and there was only one name I gave. More Taylor. Yeah, that's where it gets tough. But in all seriousness, I don't think you'll ever know how proud I am.
Let's have a drink quick.
I don't think you'll ever know how proud I am of you, Taylor. Fuck. Sorry, Granny. I'm sorry, Granny. Being a dad turned me into a pussy. Taylor, I watched you raise a daughter at a young age, and eventually I learned to be a dad from watching you with Kenzaneth. You've taught me more than you'll know, and I can't thank you enough for all the times you've been there for me. My proudest day until my son was born was the day you asked me to be Mackenzie's godfather. God. No, I didn't say it, Granny. I stopped myself. Yeah, no, I... Proudest day was the day you asked me to be Ken's godfather, and I don't know if you know how much that meant to me. And I can't wait to watch our boys grow together like we did with Kyle and Cody. Words can't describe how happy I am for you guys, and I just hope that every day feels as good as today does. So if I could get everyone to raise their glasses for a toast and possibly a chug for my happiness. But I'm so happy for this man. I love this.
Just heard from the first half of the co-groomsmen, so I'd like to invite up Taylor's other brother, the many nicknames we know him by, but Landon Weeks.
He's gonna make you laugh.
Why did everyone have to get so emotional? Like, where's the funny stories? And
I'm sure you have them.
I would first like to thank the bride and groom for inviting me to be a part of your special day. For anyone that doesn't know this, I think that Taylor is a little worried about my speech. Well, buckle up, buddy. I would actually like to start off by saying a couple things about the beautiful bride, Dallas Crystal Palace. Crystal, my mother always told you that you still have time to run and that you can't say that she didn't warn you about my brother. Well, I guess it's a little late for that. Welcome to the Weeks family. You are the salt of the earth, and I'm so happy that my brother found someone that makes him so happy. You balance my brother out when he needs it the most. You have the most patience. It literally amazes me every single day. You do realize you just married somebody that has a 50-page to-do list at all times. I don't think I've ever seen you riled up or annoyed at my brother, even when he decides to keep the night going and listens to Tyler Childers and Adam Baldwin on the back deck till 3 a.m. and falls asleep on the patio.
Not Taylor.
You have fed me countless meals, even when I was never invited. I would show up at supper time with an empty stomach, and you'd welcome me with open arms. We've had so much fun through the years, from late nights drinking at your apartment on Allen Street to competitive board game nights, which I always won, and you know that. You rock at being a mom, and I know that my nieces and nephews will always be in the best of hands. I can see how happy you make my brother, and we are also happy that you are now officially part of this crazy family. And now on to the good part, Mr. Taylor Weeks. As Taylor already mentioned, oftentimes he reminds me that I followed his footsteps in life. For instance, Taylor played rugby in high school, I played rugby in high school. Taylor went to St. FX, I went to St. FX. Taylor became a realtor, I became a realtor. But for everyone wanting to buy a house, I will actually answer my phone, so you never call this guy ever. Speaking of St. FX, I want to share a little story of the first time I visited St. FX. In my grade 12 year, after months of convincing our parents, they allowed me to go to St. FX for a weekend. Taylor lived in an all-male residence with 40 other guys where they attended church every day and studied on the weekends. After Taylor tore me around campus, showed me the library, church, meal hall, and all the other things I actually went up to see, we decided to have one or two beers. As the night went on, Taylor disappeared and I hung out with all the other well-behaved guys in the residence. Taylor later came back to discover that his little brother had a mullet. And we all discover the tailor was missing his two front teeth. Taylor was in another residence skateboarding down the hallways where he fell face first on the tile floors. Needless to say, I went home that week and sent him my application and followed in my brother's footsteps. Taylor was always the golden boy growing up between us three boys, but we didn't have much competition. As Taylor got older, Mom started realizing he wasn't the golden boy she always thought. Taylor lost a couple of brownie points at the age of 18 when my mother stopped him at the Hunter River Irving. Our sweet mother went down to the Irving to probably get Big A cigarettes when the lovely cashier congratulated her on being a grandmother. Phyllis was in complete denial and did not know what she was talking about until she called Taylor to question him, where he soon broke down crying and spilled the beans. But here we are 12 years later, Kenzie, and I could not have met our life with him. Worse than Taylor up on the aisle today. Not only is he the best father, but he's the best big brother a fella could ask for. He's the first person I go to for advice, even though I hardly ever listen to him. He is the most generous guy I know and would literally give the shirt off his back if someone needed it. He literally funded half of my backpacking trip across Europe. I backpacked through Europe solo, and coming on the end, I may or not have spent a little too much money. I would shoot Taylor a text randomly saying, how are things going? And all I would get back is, how much money do you want? And every single time, the bank of Taylor always transferred the money. I'm very lucky to be able to call my brother my business partner as well. The majority of our clients always mention how nice it is that we get to work together and how great of a team we make. They don't see the other side of things. We may argue a lot. We don't always see eye to eye on every topic. You may get mad at my driving when I'm going 140 kilometers an hour near Lincoln because we're 5 minutes late. But I wouldn't change it for the world. If one thing matters to Taylor, it's family.
You got her, buddy.
And that always comes first. Everyone that knows Taylor knows how proud he is of his three beautiful children. And I hope one day I am lucky enough to raise a beautiful family you and Crystal have. Now I want to share one story about Kentucky and the bachelor party.
No!
I'm just joking. That's the end of my speech. I'm done.
Will be given by Mackenzie Tebow.
You got this.
Water's
Let's do this.
On this
this special day of Taylor and Crystal Weeks, I want to start off by saying how grateful I am for my dad. He has been there supporting me since day one, being there for me when I need it. As hard as it was when you went to university, I stayed home with Nanny and Poppy. You always did your best talking to me throughout your day. Thank you for being my soccer coach. I know I get mad a lot and very easily, but good job for putting up with my attitude. Thank you for giving me money when I need it. Don't worry, I'll pay you back sometime soon. Keyword, maybe. Thank you for taking me to Moncton, Halifax, and Toronto. I had so much fun at the Toronto Maple Leafs games. Thank you so much for being my stepdad. I love you. I read stepmom by accident. Now let's move on to the most prettiest person I've ever seen, my new stepmom, Crystal Weeks. Crystal, even though I've only known you for almost 5 years now, you've always felt like a real mom to me since you and Dad met. As soon as I saw you, I knew that someday you would be the one marrying my dad and become my stepmom. Thank you for taking me places and having girls' days. I'm so happy to call you my stepmom. You're always there to hear my drama. Don't worry, there will be more soon, I guarantee it. Crystal, overall, I love you so much. I hope you have the best day. Congratulations to my mom and dad, Mr. and Mrs. Weeks.
Another special guest to welcome up here, one of our groomsmen who we introduced previously. We have Dasher, one of Taylor's good friends from university. We'll see if he can follow these great acts all year.
Wow, this is insane. Unbelievable speeches by everybody so far. It's like there's so many things that there's crossover between, because we know how amazing both Crystal and Taylor are. But my name's AJ Doyle. Most people call me Dasher. Some people call me AJ Dasher Doyle. And the first time I met Taylor was, or Greenhorn, as we used to call him all the time, was during Frosh Week at Santa Fex. And he had this louder than life personality, the most social butterfly, and he had the worst hair I've ever seen. It was thick, it was good, and I think the hockey hair is coming back in style, so if he grows it back, maybe there'll be a few more grays in there. But me and Taylor, we were friends right away, but we weren't best friends. His best friend for probably the... All right, good to see you. Have a good night, everyone. His best friend for Frosh Week was a friend, and this might be a little bit of an inside joke, named Petey. And he's probably either swearing right now, shaking his head, or giving me the middle finger because I'm talking about this. And that crashed and burned very soon, and then he realized that, you know, I wasn't a bad guy. And sorry. So you become friends first, and then you become brothers. And the first time I realized that we were brothers was when we punched each other in the face. Long story short, he was filming a video to become house president of McNeil. And he said, "Can you please kick me between the legs? And I want to say right after, I will do anything for the boys." And it, very stupid, I get it. We were 18 years old and that's what it was. And a switch flicked in his head and he's like, "I'm just gonna kick him." So he kicked me. And I told him after that, he got me really good. I was not feeling very well for a couple of hours. And I said, "I'm gonna get you back, but I'm not gonna tell you when." And I remember being at an off-campus party and he was just in his glory, the wings going out. He had a girl on each arm that he had no business talking to. And I got him right back. The next night, we're at that same house and he gives me a dirty look and I can tell the wires have officially crossed. He's very mad at me from ruining his evening with potentially two girls. And he had no business being there anyway. And his eyes crossed, and he punched me square in the nose. And my nose started bleeding, and he immediately felt awful. So he said, you know what, you have to hit me back. You have to hit me back. So he blindfolded himself, went on his knees in the middle of the living room, and said, put me in, coach. I'm not even ready to play. And I socked him right in the face. And from that moment on, I said, we are brothers, because we were never mad at each other for anything. We had both hit each other in the face. And I'm sure there have been many moments of Landon and Mitch and anybody else that's probably here where there's been some physicality. All that being said, if you guys know Taylor, and I think everybody here does because you're at his wedding, he cares more about his family and his friends than he does his own life and safety and liability, which is absolutely beautiful. He comes from probably the most caring, loving, supportive family, even though that's
crazy,
crazy that I've ever been a part of. And I felt part of this family for a very, very long time. The love that your parents show you, the support that they give you, and it was very evident after our first year of university when you called me into your room, probably about 3 weeks in, and you trusted me enough with a life-changing secret to say, I'm going to be a dad, to that beautiful young lady at the end of the row there, Mackenzie. And at 18 years old, the fact that you were able to complete a four-year university degree with the support of your absolutely amazing family is just, there's no way I would have been able to do that. And I think there's a lot of people in this room, there's no way that they would have ever been able to do that. You did it in 4 years. You raised an absolutely amazing daughter. You have two other beautiful kids. You are the ultimate father, and I admire you every single day. You are my best friend, and you mean the world to me, buddy. And I'm so proud to be able to call you my best friend. And Crystal, I swear I'll wrap it up quick. And Crystal, the moment I met you on Levy Day, I think it was in 2017, 18, something like that. As soon as I met you, I said, this is the person. Because anybody who, as you all know, you know Taylor, the comments that comes out of his mouth, you don't know what's coming. And anybody who can deal with that and respond with that with the grace and patience and humor that Crystal does, I said, this is his person. And over the years, you have been nothing but the best mom on the absolute planet. You have welcomed me with open arms to anything and everything. And you have just been the model of grace and beauty and kindness, and I love you, and I'm so happy that you are married to my best friend, and I consider you my best friend as well. That being said, I will wrap this up. Everybody raise your glasses, and here's to the Weekses. No, I'm just kidding. Inside joke. Everybody, here's to the Weekses. Let's have a hell of a night.
We're not quite through them yet. We have one more speech for everybody this evening, so please join me in welcoming the bride and groom, Crystal and Taylor Weeks.
As most of you know, I love the sound of my own voice. I love to talk. And I don't want to cry anymore tonight. I have this big, long speech written out, and I was working on it, and I just don't know if I want to keep crying.
Do it.
The only day you get to do it.
It doesn't matter, Dan.
Okay. But I might not read it all. Because I actually didn't maybe finish it, so there's all an excuse. It only feels right to start this off by thanking Mrs. Weeks. Doesn't that sound good? Yeah, see, now I'm just going to cry. Crystal. I knew right from the start of our relationship that we would be here today. I know my mom, as everyone also has brought up the same thing, my mom told you to run.
She did.
She said it like way too many times and like still said it like a couple weeks ago, how it's still not too late. And I'm like, well, shit. Like, but here we are. I know that we always talked about this day and it feels so damn good to finally be here. The first day I introduced you to Mackenzie, and after looking at the Christmas lights together that night in Rustico, we then went back to my parents' house, and I watched you and Ken's play. And you two have been inseparable ever since. I know it must have been challenging to go from one day of a guy overstaying his visit to then becoming a mother figure in my daughter's life instantly. You stepped up to the plate and jumped right into a completely new role in this life with open arms, and it almost felt too good to be true. I know I could keep rambling on and on and on, but I just want to keep it a little short and sweet. I love you so much. Today's been perfect. Thank everyone for coming. And there's still like 9 more paragraphs to friggin' read. Do you want to go back and forth here? Do you want to talk about me?
I'll get to you.
I want to thank my groomsmen for being with me on this special day. Either one of you could have been the best man today, but unfortunately my dad wouldn't leave my mom alone, and I have 2 brothers. It meant the world to me to have you fellas join me down in Kentucky, along with a few of the other guys in the room. And I'm really glad you guys didn't tell any stories. To the bridesmaids, I love you all. Thank you for welcoming in to your friend group instantly and putting up with all of my shenanigans. I feel so lucky that Crystal introduced me to you all. Hannah, I don't know if we would be here today without you. You didn't ask to be the wedding planner. None of this could have been done without you. A lot of stuff, everyone knows I'm a very last minute person. But thank you, Hannah, for making sure we're here. Mackenzie, we'll just talk after because I can't do that shit.
He loves to do it.
No. To Karen and Boyd, thank you for raising this beautiful, perfect, stubborn little girl of yours. It's been my pleasure getting to know you over the years, and I'm so thankful for all that you do for us. Thank you for welcoming me and Mackenzie into your family right from the start and treating us so well. Boyd, I'm sorry I suck at golf. I don't know how to swing a hammer, and my lawn will never look as good as yours, but I'll just keep trying. Karen, watching both you and Boyd become grandparents has been so special for us. Our kids are so lucky to have you as Nanny and Grampy. Thank you for treating Mackenzie just like one of your own grandchildren right from day one. I promise to love your daughter every single day and continue to raise your beautiful grandchildren with patience, kindness, and pride. I don't want to talk about my parents. To my parents, Big A and Phil Bear, I owe the world to you both. As it was also previously discussed,
When I was 18, Mackenzie came into this world, and I was terrified and anxious and had absolutely no idea how to be a dad at such a young age. I'll never take for granted how much you two helped me and helped me raise that beautiful girl down there at the end.
I can't even like see my phone.
Well, I didn't want to do this.
Let me just read it really fast.
Dad, I don't know where I'd be without you. I know we don't talk about our feelings often, but you've not only been my dad, you're my friend, my mentor, and my hero. I hope I make you proud. It's because of you I turned out to be the person I am today, and I'm so thankful we get to work beside each other every day. Although some days I know it sure doesn't feel like that. You instilled confidence and work ethic in me and taught me many of life's lessons. I know some days I don't always, it might not always, it may, geez. I know some days, actually I didn't even write the right sentence, let's laugh. That's good, let's laugh. I know some days it might not always feel like this at the office, but I do love you. Mom, I can't think of a more unselfish person in the world. You literally gave your kidney to someone else in the room.
I think it'd be better if I was like if I looked cute when I cried, but like I just ruined like all this awesome photo moment. Mom, you've been there for me at my lowest, and you've always had my back no matter what. You still love me, even though I turned you from the cool mom in high school to the cool grandmother just a few months later. I can always count on you for help, and within minutes, you're down at our house. You adore your grandkids, and we're all so blessed to have you in our life. It simply can't be put into words how much we both appreciate you and love you. And I'm going to stop reading that one now. And then that's good, because Crystal read the part about Grammy earlier, so I don't have to do that. This is awesome. I think that's done. Big thanks to all of our vendors tonight. Thank you, Pappy's Barbecue. The food was delicious. Thank you to the Carriage House and all the staff here. Melissa's team, Mel.
Sarah Weeks for
doing the cake.
Hairstylist, makeup artist.
Yeah, everyone else who was part of the day. This has been awesome.
Landon.
I thought you wanted to say something, you just wanted to be acknowledged. Okay. I think all my crying's out for today, and this is awesome. I need a drink. Crystal, I love you.
Woo! All right. Okay. Welcome, everyone. We made it. We're here. And we couldn't be more thrilled to be celebrating with all of you guys. We have the cream of the crop here. It doesn't get any better than this. So I'm a pretty social person. You probably all know that. And speeches shockingly give me anxiety. So just patient with me. I don't have a really great memory. It's like a goldfish. So. And I don't want to forget anyone, so I'm glad Taylor did the vendors. That's really great because you guys were all amazing. I'm going to do a few little thank yous. Spencer and Bailey, our amazing MCs. Can we give them a round of applause, please? I have always said how incredible all of Taylor's friends are from the moment that I met all of you. You made me feel included, loved, and a part of your awesome group, and I don't really know how to thank you guys for that. It rings so true for you two especially, Spencer and Billy. Like, Spencer, you commiserate with me on what it is like to live with Taylor and how difficult it must be. And you give me like all the sympathy I need, which is like entirely validating. Thank you so much. Bailey, oh my God, you are the sweetest person alive. Like, from the moment that I met you, I adored you. You have like the most infectious energy, and simply put, the world just needs more Baileys. So thank you both for taking on this role today and absolutely rocking it. So thank you. Love you. maid of honor, best man. I told you what I think of you. You know what I think of you. I love you to the moon and back. I love each and every one of you. And you guys look friggin' awesome. I know Taylor's taking all the spotlight, but you guys look real good too. I don't think a better lineup of human exists, really. From planning the most incredible bachelor and bachelorette parties ever, Kentucky and Nashville, helping with wedding tasks, traveling across the country for us, just keeping us sane through this whole process. You are so loved, and I cannot picture our life without all of you in it. Growing old with you guys is the best gift that we could ask for, so thank you for loving and supporting us in this wild ride of life. All right, here we get into the nitty-gritty. We'll start with Alan and Phyllis. Speaking of feeling welcome, Alan and Phyllis have made sure from day one that I feel like I belong in this crazy family. Phyllis, you're constantly saving our butts. You help with the kids. You keep us from drowning in our dishes. I don't know how you do it. I'm still trying to figure it out. You did with four kids, and I'm like at three, and I'm like, oh. You are truly a super mom and a super nanny. And not just the best nanny and poppy to our kiddos, five in total, because there's more children now. We don't own them all. And she makes sure that every one of them feels special and loved. And how amazing is that? You just seem to know when and how to step in and save us so selfless at every turn. We are so lucky to have nanny and poppy just up the road for snuggles and boxes of Smarties. And we thank you from the bottom of our hearts for all that you do. And I didn't run. But there was moments, you know, the whole gum incident, I thought about it. All right, so to my parents, there is nothing I could say to you both that would begin to explain how grateful I am to you. Your unconditional love and support has made my life far richer than I could have dreamed. To have a relationship evolve from being a parent and child to friends is such a gift. And while I do know that I will always be your baby, it is the best gift that I could receive. I always said that you were perfectly balanced parents, never too flaxy, but never too strict, which allowed me to be honest and open with you. You want to go to a party? Sure, just be home at a decent time. You want to take the car to an event? Sure, just don't drink and drive. And you want to go to a friend's house, yeah, just let us know if you need to drive home. You're always just so easy, and I could be so honest and open with you. Now, I probably wasn't always perfectly honest. There was that time where Dad found all the stolen street signs under my bed. I didn't know that was illegal. Dad let me know that that was illegal in a not-so-nice way. But anyhow, we've had a great balance and very honest communication, and that's one of the many things that you do that I'm going to try to replicate with my children. I've learned from the very best, and I love you both so much. So thank you for all that you do and all that you are. To Sarah, the best impromptu coordinator. There's nobody more genuine and kind, and just having, without even having to be asked, you just roll up your sleeves and you jump in no matter what the challenge. You are a saint, literally. Many moons ago, after beverages at Marco Polo Land, Phyllis reached her breaking point with Taylor and Landon and the shenanigans, and she told us, run. And this is where this all comes from. It was a stick of gum. It was a really old one. It was a battle. I won't get into it. It's disgusting. But she told us to run, and she said, don't ever say I didn't tell you to run. And I'm so glad we both stayed put, because I couldn't imagine navigating these crazy weeks, boys, without you. Now, to our little kiddos. Obviously, they're not here because we saw, you know, Everly had to go home and get her lipstick and her sour candies. Very important. But they are the sweetest little humans. But the one that is here, Mackenzie. my sweet girl, if only you knew how monumental you were and how this beautiful life of ours unfolded. From the moment I met you, I loved you, and I always will. I always knew someday I wanted children, but I just never knew when. When I met you, all that changed. Getting to grow with you and put it all in perspective. You made me realize that I was cut out for this. And then family really is everything, and that even though you aren't my child biologically, you hold my whole heart. You made me a mom, and how lucky am I for that. You're an amazing big sister, daughter, and friend, and I will always love you. I love you to the moon, sugar. Okay, getting there. To the Weeks family in general, just all of you guys. Something that's been a resounding theme in my life is being surrounded by people. Now I'm going to elaborate. My whole life I've always been happiest when I'm in a large group. It might be a byproduct of being an only child, and perhaps it's just a byproduct of being a really extroverted person, but I've always felt most at home surrounded by lots of family and friends, and whatever setting brings us all together. Whether it be family gatherings with aunts and uncles and cousins, that loud chaos has been a place that makes me most comfortable. Being an only child, sometimes finding that chaos out is challenges when it's just three of you under one roof. So I drove my parents crazy, always asking to drag someone along. I always had to have a friend. So all of this is to say, it feels like I found a place, like home with your family. To come into a group and feel so comfortable is such a gift. I immediately felt like I belonged. From day one, you guys didn't handle me with kid gloves. You just took me into the fold and showed me what it was like to be a part of this big chaotic scene all over again, and I loved every second of it. I said this before, but I've always wanted siblings. Someone to commiserate with about life, someone to depend on, to make you laugh when you need it, someone to annoy when you feel like it, and I don't think I could have landed a better group. I felt like I belonged from the beginning, and even when it was a weekend and Taylor sent me a snap of all of his siblings and Sam huddled on one lazy boy chair creeping my Instagram, that's when I knew. The things I can depend on, Mitch will protect my kids like his own. Landon will not let anyone mess with us, ever. Like, he can be actually scary, so we don't have to worry about a thing. And Hannah will protect me from her brothers and fight my battles for me. It's a really good system. All right. We're almost there. So a speech would not be a speech if you didn't acknowledge a little bit of sad stuff, right? So just bear with me while I get serious for 1 second. This year was a tough one. We did experience like a lot of loss and grief and difficult moments. We lost family members and friends that we held really near and dear. But while this year held loss, it also had major wins. And while I know that he may murder me after this speech, making this the shortest marriage in history, I can't be up here and not acknowledge the wins that are the highest points after the lowest lows. Oh, God, okay. This morning, after what felt like an eternity to us, we finally got the confirmation that my dear dad is cancer-free. Generous wedding gift. Nothing can top this one. The gift of time with you. The gift of time with the ones you love the most. As cliche as it may be, the takeaway from this is simple. Don't wait for big events like this to show your love for anyone or anything. Never take the ones that you love for granted. I love you. And way to rock it. It's great. All right.
There's more.
Last one. To Taylor, my husband. So the running joke, as we've heard many times, is that Taylor came to my place and he never left. And I'm not sure it can be classified as a joke if it's true. Do you remember when we first started dating, you had 10 cats, 537 pairs of socks, and 0 pairs of underwear? We've come a long way, babe. I'd like to report we have 0 cats and a reasonable amount of socks and underwear all with our holes, so we're doing good. But in all seriousness, I've spent a good portion of my life playing it safe. I can be an overthinker. And while sometimes that can be a benefit, it can also be the reason that you miss out on something great, like Amazon sales or, you know. I've always been fairly cautious not to be too impulsive. And when I met you, we were a whirlwind, and I kept thinking I was acting on impulse. But I was wrong. For the first time in so long, I was acting on instinct. I knew in my soul that your soul was so good and so kind and so perfect for me. And what I learned was, in the end, when you relinquish the control you think you have over life, and you learn to ride with it and experience the heartache and the challenges, you can also experience a lot of beauty, which is what I found here at the end of the day. My instinct was so spot on with you, and I couldn't be more lucky to have found my home. I am so proud of all that you are and all you are becoming. And I know this life has so much more beauty in store for us and our family. I love you now and always until the wheels fall off.
Breaking out. Yeah, we're breaking out. heartbeat. It only been 8 weeks. Standing there at that screen was the first time you ever scared me. God knows I don't know exactly what I'm doing, but good news, we got her to get through it. I hope you love just like your mama and love her like I do. You'll see close to perfect patience if you watch her every move. You can always run to daddy, you'll always be my baby. But look at her, baby girl, and you'll learn how to be a lady.
Thank you. 5 foot high, full of grace, full of pride. She saw me coming a mile away. So far from heaven, no chance I would get it. She didn't see me that way. The devil only knows the sinner I would be. But the mama raised the hell out of me. Yeah, mama raised the hell out of me.
I wrote this song a long, long time ago. I wrote this song a long, long time ago. And it goes, I wanna see you all dressed up in white. Baby, I'm gonna love you for the rest of my life. And I told you since I met you that you'd always be mine. And one day I was gonna make you my wife. But baby, tonight, tonight I'm gonna make you my wife. As far as feelings go, that's the best feeling I've ever known. As far as where I wanna be, well, if you're there, that's my home. Everybody, raise your glasses and holler.